Sorry, not ready. Getting a letter here and there. Whew. That was the last ship. I hope the captain will be satisfied now.
Unlikely. He was determined to put these men to rest himself.
But he would have never been able to.
That does not matter to him. Our victory will only remind him of his failure.
Then, why do we do this?
Finish that story you started?
I can indeed. Where were we? Oh, Thor smashes the stone head of Runia, who falls upon him with a sickening crunch. And again, the roars of laughter echo through the palace halls.
That's an awful story, Mimir. Nothing like the ones Mother told me.
Let that be a lesson, my son. Truth is seldom so pretty as myth and legend.
Thank you. lucky who decided to show. Talk to this here ring.
What? I can't hear thoughts from rings, Brock. It's talking to me! It's Invari!
Ha! Knew it.
He says he went to the Velander mines to observe his mistake, but then the Soul Eater attacked, so as he was being ripped apart, he cast a spell that removed his soul and put in this ring. And then he...
What about all his stuff? Anvari had a workshop here with all sorts of posh doodads and ornatory tools, and one beaut of a hammer. You make mention of it still in there?
You're upsetting him.
Your point? You fellas take Anvari with you and go have a look-see. If you find his hammer, I'll whip up something real nice for you. Hey now, don't go forgetting your entry stone. Let's get to it. Another time, then.
Invari isn't happy about us taking the stuff.
I do not care.
I'm not gonna tell him that. Invari says this dwarf was part of his crew, that he died because of his mistakes. He sounds sad.
The ring's grief is of little importance, boy.
Did not like that. He's warning us not to go down there.
Stop listening to the ring, boy. Cannot be trusted.
Oh!
silence that ring, boy.
I don't know how!
Look here.
Hey, it's another treasure map.
And a traveler. Guard up.
A dead soul eater. What's a soul eater even doing here? What do you mean it's your fault?
Boy, ignore him.
It's sort of tough for me to ignore.
Thank you.
says this chest will trigger a bunch of traps.
I see no traps.
You sounded so sure about it. Shop is up there. But I know. Don't trust the talking ring.
Oh!
Father, please, just listen. Invari's crew did something bad here. He's glad you destroyed his life, and he's sorry you kept trying to trick us. His hammer is just through this gate.
Here. Boy.
Yes, sir.
This is a fine hammer.
Invari says thank you.
We will talk to the blue one.
Prepare yourself!
Here, the alchemist's hammer. His spirit is a nuisance.
Yeah, Anvari always was an asshole. Hell of an alchemist, though. Hand him over here and I'll melt him down.
What? You're going to melt down your friend?
A trapped soul's what I need to give your reward some extra oomph. You don't want it?
Father, we can't do that. Here, you hold on to him. He's really useful, I promise.
Fine. So long as he proves his worth.
Kid's a bit of a softy, huh? Well, he'll grow out of it. To work it is! Good stuff. So, you sticking around for grains of wisdom?
I have a question. If Ymir was the first giant, where did he come from?
In the beginning, there was Ganungagap, the great void. There were no realms yet, only primordial forces. There was fire, and there was ice. And there in the void, they met and produced...
water?
More than water. The mystic lifeblood of something entirely new. From this water, Ymir took form and became a being of pure creation and chaos, mother and father to all that came after.
Even the Aesir?
Aye. Every god, man, and beast came first from Ymir's flesh. Though it was the Aesir who thought themselves so superior that they should hold dominion over the rest of creation. It was Odin who took arms against his creator and spilled Ymir's lifeblood with his spear. A necessary evil, he would say, to bring order to the realms. Ymir's torn flesh, Odin would fashion the realm of Midgard for his own. You know what? I'll tell this one later. Our story was in need of a conclusion. Odin had slain Ymir and used the primeval giant's flesh to shape the realm of Midgard. Called himself All-Father as if he was the creator and not the creator's destroyer. A small, covetous tyrant.
Ymir?
Huh? Oh, sorry, my boy. You know, I think at best we just end it there, actually.
We can translate those Niflheim runes.
Thank you.
another map. Great.
Enemies ahead!
Need more time! How was that?
Adequate.
Striking.
Correct. A cunning one as well.
Is that Mjolnir? Did he steal Thor's hammer?
Aye, for a time.
A lot of these seem to end with Thor killing them.
Imagine that.
Another name. Car!
It It's as if they've been made into a memorial to the Valkyries.
Down there. Mimir, why don't you tell us the story of the giant that stole Thor's hammer?
Happily, my boy. It involves your friend Freya, too, though I don't expect it's one she'd enjoy being reminded of. The giant was called Thrym. And he proved cunning enough to make off with Mjolnir while the Thunderlummox slept. But I can't tell you this story later.